स्टैंडर्ड 9 साइंस चैप्टर 8 मोशन सम और प्रैक्टिकल प्रॉब्लम एग्जांपल 8.1 फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन एन ऑब्जेक्ट ट्रैवल 16 मीटर इन 4 सेकेंड सो Distance travel
सर स्पॉटलाइट कर दो ना
ओके Distance traveled is 16 meter in 4 seconds and then another 16 meter in 2 seconds. So, total distance traveled will be 16 plus 16, 32 meter. Now, total time will be 2 seconds plus 2 seconds. It will be total 4 seconds. Total 4 seconds. What is the average speed? Average speed is equals to total distance traveled upon total time taken. Total distance is 32 upon 4, so 8 meter per second. This is your average speed. Why meter per second? Why meter per second? It is 32 meter divided by 4, 8 meter per second is the final answer of your sum. 8 meter per second. Now question number 2, example 2. Example 8.2, the odometer. Do you know what is odometer? Anyone can guide me? Do you know the odometer?
Kilometer mapanu machine.
Okay, the machine which is used to measure the kilometer in bike, car or any vehicle, right? So odometer of car reads 2000 kilometer at the start. Initial reading 2000 kilometer. Final reading, it reached 2400 kilometer. So what he actually traveled? Distance traveled is equals to 2400 minus 2000, that is 400 kilometer. If the trip took 8 hours, now time is given also. 8 hours. Time is also given. Calculate the average speed of the car in kilometer per hour and then meter per second. Average speed is equals to total average speed is equals to total distance traveled upon total time taken 400 by 8 that is 50 kilometer per hour. 50 kilometer per hour. Now I have explained, if we wish to convert kilometer per hour, bigger unit, from meter per second, smaller unit, what will we do? We will divide them, multiply them by 5 upon 18. Why is it so? Why? Because here it is 1 meter is equals to 1000 kilometer, and 1 hour is equals to 3600 seconds. So if we reduce them, the number will come 5/18. The number will come 5/18. Let's reduce. It is here 9. It is 25. So 125/9. Final answer we can write will be divided by 125/9. It will be approximately 13.9 meter per second. 13.9 meter per second. Two answers. Average speed in kilometer per hour is 50, and meter per second, that is smaller unit, 13.9 meter per second. Got it? Everyone got it?
Yes,
everyone
sir.
Got it? Say yes. Okay.
Yes.
Then
yes,
I can
sir.
Start next. Arham?
Huh?
I have a news for you. You can purchase science part 1 from that Adinath stationer. They have it. Right? Okay, next. Example 8.3. Usha swims in a 90 meter long pool. 90 meter long means to and fro. If you go and come back, it will be total 180 meter. She covers 180 meter in 1 minute by swimming from one end to the other and back along the same straight path. So, total distance is equals to 180 meter. And total time one minute is equals to 60 seconds. So what they want us to find, average speed is equals to total distance upon total time. We can also write in a symbolic form, huh? How? We can write VAV. This is a symbol of average speed. Total distance is S upon T. 180 meter upon 60 seconds. So it will be 3 meter per second. It will be 3 meter per second average speed. It will be 3 meter per second. Now, average velocity. Now, if this is a track of swimming and she jumps from here and travels and again come back to the same path. Now, my question is that what will be the displacement? What will be the displacement?
Sir, zero.
Very good. It is 0 meter because she came at the same place from where she started, right? So displacement is zero. Now average velocity. If we wish to count, we should have total displacement upon total time. What is the total displacement? Total displacement is zero and total time 60. So it is 0 meter per second. It is 0 meter per second. Got it? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Question of velocity.
Yes, sir.
Now. Example 8.4. Starting from a stationary position, Rahul pedals his bicycle to attain a velocity of 6 m/s in 30 seconds, starting from zero. So what I can write, initial velocity u is equals to zero. Final velocity is 6 m/s. In 30 seconds, that is time 30 seconds. So then he applies brakes such that velocity of bicycle comes down to 4 m/s. In the next 5 seconds, calculate the acceleration of the bicycle in both the cases. This is case one, from 0 to 6 m, from 0 m to 6 m. So acceleration A is equals to V minus U upon T. V is 6 - 0/30. 6 by 30, if we reduce them, it is 1/5, or we can write 0.2 m/s². It is 0.2 m/s² from 0 to 6. Now, second situation. Situation 2. This is situation 1. From 0 to 6. Now, this is from 6 m/s to 4 m/s. So, initial velocity I can write here u is 6 m/s. Final velocity is 4 m/s. Time taken is 5 seconds. So, A is equals to V minus u upon T. 4 - 6/5. That is -2/5. -0.4 m/s². -0.4 m/s². Or I can write, it is retardation or deceleration or negative acceleration. Retardation is 0.4 m/s². If we write acceleration, we should write negative here. But if we write retardation, we should write positive here. Because retardation itself is negative. Retardation itself is negative. If we write, once again, I am repeating. Acceleration, if you write, it is -0.4 m/s². But if you write retardation or negative acceleration, it means 0.4 m/s². Got it? Everyone got it? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Absolutely or any doubt?
No, sir.
Absolutely or any doubt?
No, sir.
No doubt. No doubt. Okay. Okay. Now, example 8.5. If you are more interested in this type of sum, I can give in homework also, if you wish. Example 8.5. Example 8.5. A train starting from rest attains a velocity of 72 km/h in 5 minutes. A train starting from rest attains a velocity of 72 km/h in 5 minutes. Starting at rest, that is initial velocity, is 0 m/s. Final velocity is 72 km/h. Now we should convert it in meter per second compulsory. Every sum you should count with meter per second only. So 72 × 5/18, 18 fours are, if we cut 5 fours are, 20 m/s is the final velocity in 5 minutes. Time given is 5 minutes. Time given is 5 minutes. Again, we'll convert in seconds. So 5 × 60, that will be 300 m/s. That will be 300 m/s. Now find first acceleration. acceleration A is equals to V minus U upon T. What will be acceleration? It will be 20 meter per second minus 0 meter per second upon 300 second. So 20 by 300, if we reduce it, it will be 1 upon 15 meter per second square. If we reduce 2 upon 30, it will be 1 upon 15 meter per second square. Or we can write 1 upon 15 meter second raised to minus 2. If we do not write in a denomination form. Right? This is the basic concept. Now, what second question they want us to find? The distance traveled by train for attaining this velocity. For distance. We can use two formula for distance. We have taken S is equals to 1 half UT plus 1 half AT square, or 2AS is equals to V square minus U square. Any of these two you can apply. For distance, for distance traveled, we can use 2AS is equals to V square minus U square. Now see, acceleration A is 1 upon 15. S we have to find because it's a distance. V square, what is V? It is 20 whole square minus U square, that is 0 whole square. So what we can do, we keep it S here. 20 square, that is 400. 15, which is here in denomination, we take it on the other side of equal to, it will be 15. Multiplication, ma, right? It will come in multiplication and put it 2 in a division form. So 2s are 200. 15 2s are 3000 meter, or we can write 3 kilometer also. We can write 3 kilometer also. 15,000 meter or 3 kilometer. Let me explain it again. Let me explain. Example 8.6. Car accelerates uniformly from 18 kilometer per hour to 36 kilometer per hour. Initial 18 kilometer per hour. We can convert them into meter per second. So 5 upon 18. 18, 18 we can cut. So it will be 5 meter per second. Final velocity V is equals to 36 kilometer per hour. So 36 into 5 upon 18. 18 2s are 5 2s are 10 meter per second. Final velocity in 5 seconds. Time is given 5 seconds. Time is given 5 seconds. Calculate first acceleration. Acceleration. Acceleration A is equals to V minus U upon T. V is equals to 10 minus 5 upon 5. 5 by 5, that is 1 meter per second square. 1 meter per second square is your acceleration. Now, second question they want you to find is distance covered by the car in that time. Distance covered. Distance covered is equals to we can use any of the formula. We are doing this sum with both the formula, right? In textbook, it is given S is equals to UT plus 1 half AT square. Now, initial velocity is 5. Time taken is again 5. Right? 1 half. Acceleration is 1. And time again 5. Into 5. 5 5 is 25. Here 5 5 is 25 divided by 2. That is 12.5. So, total 37.5 meter. This is the distance covered by car. 35, 37.5. Now again, we are using a different formula also. 2as is equals to v square minus u square. 2, acceleration is 1 into s. V square is 10 square. U square is 5 square. Therefore, s is equals to 100 minus 25 divided by 2. 75 by 2, it is 37.5 meter. Either you use formula of distance covered, this one or this one. Both the way, answer will be same. Both the way, answer will be same. Got it or not, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Got it or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, last illustration of this book. Then we'll start exercise.
सर लीव थी गया Okay. Example 8.7. The brakes applied to a car produce an acceleration of 6 meters per second. Square. Brakes applied, so it is negative acceleration, minus 6 meters per second square, in the opposite direction to the motion. If the car takes 2 seconds to stop after the application of brake, time taken is 2 seconds, final velocity v is equals to zero. Calculate the distance it traveled during the time. Now, first of all, we do not have initial velocity. So, we can use v is equals to u plus at, or either we can use a is equals to v minus u upon t, c
same formula. If you do not remember this one, you can apply this one also. V 0 U plus A minus 6 into 2 minus 12. Sorry. So U is equals to 12 meter per second. U is equals to 12 meter per second. Now S is equals to UT plus 1/2 AT square. UT plus 1/2 AT square. U 12. Time is 2. 1/2. Acceleration is value minus 6. And this is 2 square. 12 2s are 24. Plus 1/2. 6 4 is 24 minus. If we cut minus 12, 24 minus 12, it will be 12 meters. So after applying brake, it will travel for 12 meters and then it will stop. It will travel for 12 meters and then it will be stopped. Now, again, we can find by different formula 2as is equals to v square minus u square. 2 into minus 6 into S, V square is 0 minus U is 12 square. Minus 12 into S is equals to minus 144. S minus 144 upon minus 12. So S will be 12 meter. We can obtain this answer by both the method. By both the method. Either applying this formula or this formula. Right? You can do anyone. You can do any. Exercise. Chapter 8. Motion. Sum number 1. An athlete completes one round of circular track of diameter 200 meter. This is 200 meter in 40 seconds. Right? So what is that time taken? Sorry. 40 seconds. What will be the distance covered and the displacement at the end of 2 minutes 20 seconds? Now see, diameter is 200 meter. Therefore, radius will be 100 meter. Radius will be 100 meter. Now, we should do 40 seconds. It can complete one round. So, he can complete one round in 40 seconds. Then 2 minutes. Total time 2 minutes 40 seconds. Total time 2 minutes 20 seconds. 2 minutes means 120 seconds plus 20. So total 140 seconds. So 40 second, if he can complete 40 second, one round, 80 second, two round, 120 second, three round, right? And left out 20 second, it can complete half round. So 140 divided by 40, total 3.5 round. Now distance covered, you have to use here uniform circular motions formula. Distance is equal to 2 pi r, that is circumference. Circumference 2 into 22 by 7 into radius 100. Now, this is for one round. Here completed 3.5 round. So what we will do for total distance? We'll multiply 3.5. So 2 into 22 by 7 into 100, 35 upon 10. 7, 5, 5, 2, 10. So 2200 meter he traveled. 2200 meter he traveled. Total distance he traveled is 2200 meter. What will be the distance covered? You got it? What is the displacement? Now, displacement, what it will be? Just see here. He had completed one round. For example, started from this place, one round. Again, one round. Again, one round. And at the fourth part, when he started here, he reached here. So, half round. So what is the displacement? Displacement is equals to diameter. You just reach from this place to this place. Diameter. Diameter is 200 meter. So displacement will be 200 meter and distance will be 2200 meter. Displacement will be 200 meter. That is diameter and displacement is 2200 meter. Got it? Any doubt in this sum?
Sir, it was
let us do it once again. Let us do it once again. No problem. Time taken here is 40 seconds. He complete one rotation in 40 seconds. Now, we have taken total time 2 minutes and 20 seconds. So, it will be 140 seconds. This is just I have done to explain you that 40 seconds, one round, 80 seconds, two round, 120 seconds, three round. We can directly do this 140 divided by 40. It will be approximately 3.5 round. Exactly 3.5 round. Now distance he covered will, in one round it can cover 2 pi r distance. That is circumference. That is circumference of circle, 2 pi r. Now if we have done 3.5 round. So multiply these numbers with 3.5. You will get 2200 meter. We will get answer 2200 meter he traveled. Right? Now, displacement will be, it is equivalent to diameter because after completion of one round, it is at the same place. So, no displacement. Again, same place, no displacement. Again, same place, no displacement. But here in this case, half this displacement, right? Of half round. Half round, that is diameter from this place to this place. So, diameter is equal to 200. That will be your displacement. Got it? Everyone? Everyone got it?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
If you understand, then only say yes. Otherwise, no. I will repeat again and again. I will repeat again and again.
Right? Yes, sir.
Sum number 2. Joseph jogs from one end A to another end B of a straight 300 meter road in 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
Now, and then turns around and jogs 100 meter back to point C in another 1 minute. Now let me draw it. From point A to B, it takes 300 meter total distance, right? And time 2 minutes and 30 seconds. Now he returns same line straight way 100 meter, point C. And that is also in 1 minute. Getting from figure you can have a clear idea. Now what is the question here? What are Joseph's average speed and velocities in jogging? First, from point A to B, average speed is equals to total distance upon total time. Total distance is 300 meter and total time they have taken 2 minutes 30 seconds. 2 minutes 30 seconds means 150 seconds. So divide 150 seconds. So 300 divided by 150, 2 meter per second. 2 meter per second is his average speed. Now average velocity. Average velocity. Here it will be total displacement upon total time. Total displacement, here again, here he is moving in a straight line. That's why the velocity is also 300. Right? Displacement is also 300 meter upon 150 second. So it will be 2 meter per second. It will be 2 meter per second, same. Velocity and speed are same. Why it is same? Because the direction is same. Direction is same. Now second, in second situation, they want to find from A to C. From A to C, so first of all, total distance will be 300 plus 100, 400 meter, right? From A to B, 300 plus B to C, 100. So total 400 meter. Total displacement, is C. First he traveled 300, then he comes back in the same line, 100 meters. So 200 meter is a displacement. 200 meter is the displacement. Total distance 400 meter, total displacement 200 meter. Now, total time taken is here 150 seconds and here 1 minute, that is 60 seconds. So 210 seconds. Total time 210 seconds. Now we are dividing the sum in two parts. Average speed is equals to S upon T. Total distance is 400 by 210. That is 1.9 meter per second approximate value. And average velocity is equals to
total displacement upon total time 200 divided by 210, 200 divided by 210, that is 0.952 meter per second, 0.952 meter per second.